Hi, John and Teresa here. Teresa, I got a question.
Yes.
What do you call someone that follows Jesus?
I call them a Christ follower.
That's what we do. You know, in our day, I was thinking about this, reading about this, in our day of labels and titles and words or say this, don't say this. You know, what do you call someone that follows Jesus Christ? Well, you look into the New Testament and they had different names, you know, for a while. Brethren and saints and believers. And then Acts chapter 11, the one that stuck was Christian. Christian. And Christian means one who follows Jesus Christ. And so here's the question. And the thought was this, because they looked at these people, and when they saw these people, they said, they look like the one they follow.
That's beautiful.
Do we look like the one we follow? And that's our desire, that's our prayer, that we are fully devoted followers of Jesus Christ, that we wear that title and we wear it well. We represent Jesus Christ in this culture.
That is very challenging.
Yes, it is.
I don't think I look like a follower of Jesus at all times. I can get a bad attitude. I can say things not nicely. You know, right? I mean,
we don't
look like Jesus all the time, but that's certainly...
And we want to. That's our heart's desire.
Yeah.
And I'm so thankful
that's
he takes that.
That's a challenge,
that.
For sure.
Yeah. And so this...
How do you do that? By just getting in his presence, really.
Exactly. Yeah. This compassionate Jesus, this loving Jesus, this caring Jesus, and also a Jesus who spoke truth and the culture in which he lived. And those followers, compassionate, loving... But when we look at them, they spoke truth. And when the religious leaders in Judaism says, stop preaching in the name of Jesus, they said, we're going to be God-pleasers, not man-pleasers. Yeah. They turned the Roman Empire upside down. We're going to be God-pleasers, not man-pleasers. And I pray that we truly follow Jesus Christ, represent him well, do it with right hearts, right attitudes. That only comes by being in the presence of Jesus Christ. And so we love you. God bless you. We look forward to seeing you this Sunday, Quakertown or Pittsburgh. Have a great week.
Amen. Can I say one more thing? Please make sure you read on in the
Announcements
this week, because there's a couple important announcements that you'll want to catch. Okay? God bless. See you Sunday.